Hello, hello! I am back on the road to completion. In the last episode, we leveled to level 77, and we did quite a lot of the Captain Scarlet DLC. And in this one, I want to continue farming a little bit of XP, and probably get started on another DLC, like Tiny Tina's or Torg. Not really Sir Hammerlock. And we also got a Zero Fuse Longbow Quasar last episode, which is something I actually want to use at some point. Like, what better singularity grenade can you have, right? Maybe one that slags, but... Oh. Alright. One shot. Oh, he moved! Okay. That was better. Hey, we got a pearl. The Unforgiven with a lot of grip. And an Eta. Oh, what is that? Well. Cool. We don't really need the Unforgiven, especially not level 77. No, we are arriving at the point where our gear isn't that overleveled anymore. But we're still strong enough. The only thing that gets me a little bit worried is going from level 80 immediately into overpower level 8. But I guess if we just start farming a level 88 B-Shield first, that will solve a lot of our problems. I'm gonna leave those chests now, because there isn't really anything they can give me now. Yeah, there's the one shot. WTF? Oh, normally you can only get that from Tubbies. Or as a world drop, I guess. That's a cool find. So I'm not quite sure at to what point I want to keep killing Uranus, or not Saturn. But at least till halfway till level 78. Ooh, perfect jump. Now actually, for farming this XP, I should probably equip the Fable Turtoise and the Afterburner. Let's get fast. So the only thing we do less damage in now is corrosive damage, but actually quite noticeable. Don't shoot me, don't down me. Your lies deceive you, an illusion. But as you can see, we are fast as hell. Stormfront, but homing. I do like the Stormfront a lot. It's great for a melee build if you have a Zero Fuse on it, especially with Longbow. Because the Stormfront continuously does damage, so you can basically throw it out with your Grog Nozzle equipped, and you'll heal for a ton. And it's instant healing, unlike a Transfusion Grenade. Also very useful to strip your own shield if you have a Roid Shield. So yeah, Stormfront is the way to go for melee build. Or Chain Lightning. Maybe the Chain Lightning is even better, actually. Because then you won't down yourself if you ran out of enemies.
And I disappear, a ghost amidst the combat, preparing to strike.
Yeah, maybe I should equip the Bone of the Ancients. The Hammer Buster? Ow. What? I was just about to reset anyways. Let me double check if the patch is running. Actually it is, because we have the Afterburner Relic. Otherwise that would be a... Well, still an Afterburner Relic, but wouldn't give movement speed. It would only give speed in vehicles. Did that. Oh yeah, there's more to bore, of course. Why shouldn't I use that? Hey, that is a Logan's gun? No, wait. I was literally hovering it. Was that a nasty surprise? I wasn't reading. Slag, a nasty surprise, and a sham? 84? But that's level 77. I think I have a OP 8. Or level 80. Yeah, it's also 84%. Okay, so that's just better. Yeah. And especially with Zero, farming the Sham is actually quite fast, because the Bunker dies super fast to Boar. With that broken hitbox of his. Here we go. Oh boy. Second wind. Oh, that is not a legendary. I thought I saw one. Oh, a pearlescent. The bear cat. With a Jacob's grip, yeah. There's the doorway. Oh, that's one of the turrets down. And okay, well, legendary hunter, yeah. Hey, Rainbow Runner. We didn't even have that yet. And the electric chair. Oh wait, isn't that... I was talking about the Stormfront and the Chain Lightning. But the electric chair might be even better. Wow, that's the first time I got that runner skin. Let's unlock that. Awesome. And the electric chair... It's always lobbed. 821,000. It's less damage than the Quasar. Although you won't use the quasar for damage anyways. But let's just keep it for now. It might become useful in some way. That was the legendary hunter, and yeah, that was a successful run. That's two uniques. Well, actually three uniques, but I didn't need the hunter class mod. But I'm in two like new drops. Like getting skins is always fun. Unless you're really farming for a weapon that you desperately need. Like for example, if you farm bunker and you get the head drop, there's a head customization for Salvador, I think that drops. Because it basically, if you get the skin dropped, then it means you won't get the sham shield. At least I think that's how it works. Let's do another one if there's one chance. I think I'm getting the hang of this, guys. Impetuous Hellfire. That was a purple skin. Virulent skin. And it's now like halfway through January in Rotterdam, and it's kind of cold. Like my fingers are a little bit not frozen, but they are they normally move more fluently. Not with this kind of weather. So I just turned up the radiator a little bit. Let's see if that helps. Okay, nothing useful. Oh! Maggie. I wonder over time how many legendaries or perlistens I'm gonna miss because of them flinging away like that. Oh! Love that button. So we're already past the halfway point to 78. And I'm not bored yet, so that's a good sign. Oh, there goes one of the turrets. At least that gave me follow through, so. Still a relatively fast kill. Neogenator. Lots of money. No iridium. Oh yeah, that's the Neogenator. Like, I'm wondering, is there anything else that we could use? Because getting that quasar was pretty good, like the skin and the electric chair. Although the electric chair, yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be using that at OP10. Maybe if it's on level, but actually, I probably will. But I wasn't counting on getting anything useful at all, so I guess we already exceeded my expectations.
How hilarious. You just set off my trap card.
It feels like if you bore him instantly, his loot flies a lot further away. Invader? Wait, that is a drop from Saturn. You're not Saturn. Oh. He got me. So yeah, this is a pretty chill farm. At some point we're gonna take off this afterburner relic and fable turtoise, and all of a sudden the game will feel very slow. That's a striker with Jacob's grip. It's matching, right? Yeah, it's Jacob's. Cool. But honestly, the striker is a pretty bad weapon. It is very useful for Macromancers that need to stack and get a whole lot of reloads in. Because if you have a striker with a tedier grip, then it will have less of a magazine size. So basically one shot per magazine. And it will make you reload faster as well. Especially if you have the reload prefix on it. That's a pretty fast way to stack Anarchy. Really boring playstyle, though. I mean, the playstyle is fun with Anarchy, but the stacking process is not something I want to rely on to do damage. But honestly, if you want to get a meaningful amount of critical ascension stacks, most of the time you need to pre-stack that as well. That's just as boring. Another hunter. Well, I guess that makes sense. I have a mod that only allows deliverance. I have a mod that only allows me to find class mods for the class I'm currently playing, or for classes that are joining me in co-op. That does mean that if I want to farm for example, a chaotic evil monk class mod for like Salvador, I have to do that on my Salvador, but otherwise, it's a great addition. And the thing is, class mods, you have to farm on tubbies anyways. At least if you want the UVHM ones. Yay. Deliverance again? That's twice in a row. That's weird. Almost level 78 already. Quite fast. I'm really looking forward to doing the peak again. Those last two overpower levels. But I'm also kind of worried that it will be pretty hard. Another 84% sham? And the cradle, oh no. Never use the cradle, guys. Don't do it. And if you're curious as why not to, just try it out for a few levels. Or a mission, at least. A mission in which you have to do combat, that is. Don't squish me.
Nailed it.
Alright. This way, right? Yeah. So this is gonna be the level 78 kill. For some reason he hit me. I guess he was aiming for my oh, the gub! Marksman's gub with a matching grip. Wow. Skill measure and another skin. What is that rarity called? Fluorescent or
what is next?
Not fluorescent, but it is something with rescent. Not pearlescent. Oh wait, skull measure and striker. Oh yeah, sidewinder. I think that's the reload prefix. And it does have a TDR grip. Wow. Is that the one which does the one shot? Let me check. No. Oh wait, sidewinder is actually ammo prefix, isn't it? It would have been perfect otherwise, like Hyperion stock, which really doesn't matter at all. TD or grip, but sidewinder actually gives it magazine size increase. Damn. Well, I mean, I don't play Macromancer anyway, so I really don't care.
Well, well.
Although it's one of those finds that you can just keep in one of your in your bank spaces until you decide to make a Macromancer with an Anarchy build. But you could always farm for one from the... There's a mission in... Opportunity? No, not Opportunity. I forgot how the area is called, but it's basically where you have to get the supply beacon. And that's gonna get eaten by a Thresher. If you unlock that area, there is a mission from Sir Hammerlock in the Sanctuary in which you have to kill some kind of octopus. That one drops a striker. If you're lucky, that is. Ooh, that was not a good boar. Oh boy, am I dead? I'm gonna get a second win, but... Oh yeah, you can get it from a turret. Shooting me. Hey, another sham. 85% this time. Very cool.
Well, well.
And wait. Okay, unlocked. And another electric chair. And again, 0.6 second fuse. It is a level higher though, but... I guess I can drop the old one. Like, we're not gonna use that. It's too low leveled. There you go. Join your friend. Ooh, a Carnage casual as well. Wow, that is insane, but Hyperion grip though, and level 78. Casual Carnage, I've never found a casual. Oh, and here, a Deliverance. If only those grips were switched. I could have used the Torque one on this. Yeah, I guess this is gonna be my
nice
farming spot for the Carnage and the Butcher. Like, I know the binary boss at the end of the peak will drop a guaranteed pearl after OP8. But it's just, this is just so much faster and less effort. Now the Carnage is actually a shotgun that I love using, especially on Krieg. If you get your Bloodlust stacks with that, oh man, it does so much damage and the reload speed is so fast. And of course, a shotgun that shoots rockets is pretty damn cool, like come on. Gotta love some of the designs in this game. Oh, did I? Nope. There was one more turret and I found it. Thrusting, oh, whoa. Unkempt Herald. Well, I guess there's no enemies to get a second wind on. And I don't see any particularly good loot, so I know there's some iridium, but whatever. Don't want to have to run back just to reset after. So I'm curious, we started recording like 26 minutes ago and we've already done more than a level. That's impressive. And at this point I just want to get to level 80 and start the peak. Or at least prepare for the peak. Now I could do this even faster if I don't even look at the drops, but like come on, he drops so much, like I can't help myself, I have to look at these drops. Oh, I just ruined that second win. Oh, there is a legendary. That's also a negotiator, or a neogenator, negotiator, neogenator. Maybe the impaler, it was hard to see, but not any of the shields that are particularly useful for me. That's for sure. And come on, what can beat the antagonist at this point? Actually, at this point I'm using a level 20 Fabled Turtoy shield. Another Hunter class mod. And some iridium. So I guess from this point on, if I make new characters and level them up to level eighty, of course, they won't be able to use like my old OP8 gear, because that will be scaled to level 80 now. Rockets. Oh. Yeah, there's a pearl all the way in the back. And I still got hit by those rockets? Come on. Man. What is that? Quickly! I'm stuck. I can't move there. I really want to see what that pearl is. I just lost $6 million just to check out what that blue beam on the ground is. And it's a Bearcat. With a Jacob's Grip once again. Fire though. Haven't had many of those. Oh, there's another pearl. No, wait, that. Oh. It looked like a pearl, okay? Look at that. That looks light blue. Kerblaster. Alright, I'm losing time. Oh, there's the invader. Oh. Kinda went the wrong way there. I'm really contemplating on just staying here at, until level 80, but that might be a bit boring. But then again, what else should I do up to level 80? I mean, Tiny Tina's DLC is pretty fun, but it's not particularly fast XP. Oh, hello! Another casual carnage with another Hyperion grip. What? Why, game? Why? And another pearl. Was that the Avenger? In no element? Brisk. And that is, I think that's a Dahl grip, isn't it? Splasher Blaster. Man, two casual carnages in a row. Like I just said, I never had that gun. In casual, there it is. I mean, it's cool, but like, why would I keep a level 78 gun? Even if I transfer it, like, it's gonna be replaced in two levels, though. It's not like it's mandatory to use that one for the peak on something like Krieg or Axton. But yeah, Krieg and Axton are definitely the ones that make the best use out of grenade damage. At some point I also need to level my Krieg. I'm really happy I did my Salvador already, but Krieg is gonna take even longer than zero, I think. Maybe I can farm on Pyro Pizza or something, I don't know. We'll see. First, we gotta farm a lot of gear for zero. And I guess we won't do that with Krieg. Oh! Like, what is that? Damage over time, that's getting me. Splat gun, and oh, that's a grenade. Yeah, I saw that. No more legendaries. Oh, we're exactly at the halfway point to 79. Wait, was I using my fire Pimpernel there? Oh no. Gonna down me. You know what? I'm just gonna kill him this time and don't grab the loot. He's dead, right? Yeah, he is. That was not a smooth kill though, but I accidentally killed his turrets with a fire Pimpernel. It is a lot easier to farm than Saturn, though. He actually has crit spots, and I think he also can be slagged, although not visually. He probably also has the grenade resist damage resistance, just like Saturn. But I don't really care about that. Ooh, I think I saw a pearlescent there, so that might be worth checking out. Oh, big thumper. Could be fun. Yep. Where is it? Wait. Am I delusional? Okay, whatever. That's a speed run to 79 and save level 80 for the next episode. What? I got stuck. This surely is a lot faster than questing, let me tell you. And yes, I will have to do some quests once I already leveled to the level cap. But it also means that once I get good quest rewards, I can actually I don't have to avoid them. I can just pick them up. Stand still. Let's see if I can do it without the... No. That was a terrible idea. I should have definitely death-marked him. Let's go. No thanks, Exploder. Not today. Here we go. It's about 3 more kills till 79. I wish it was 3 more for 80. Yep. Go ahead. Yeah, there we go. He wobbles too much. Luckily, this is a very good Pimpernel. Hey, Scory Light. Was that. Okay. I told you, Exploder, not today, so. If that means giving up on all that loot, that is fine with me. Pearl, the Stalker and Fire elements. Then there's the Transformer Shield. It does have a matching grip, but the Stalker is such a bad gun though. Like, why would I ever use that? Or what would I use it for? Like, I know why you could use it, like, it seems fun. I think the Stalker is the one with the... doesn't have the homing missile projectiles? Or, no, that's the Wanderlust. Maybe I should have checked it out before safe quitting. Oh well. Gotta get that XP fast. There we go, level up. And the skin again. Plus a torrent submachine gun. And a cradle. Don't slag. And iridium. Alright, so one more point in unforeseen. And we basically have one leftover point, and I guess we can just put that in kill confirmed after we reach 80, that is. Or one point in resurgence, maybe. That might just be enough to save us from dying sometime. Oh, okay. Alright, this is the episode for now. We leveled 2 levels, and that's plenty for one. So thank you for watching, and in the next episode, we'll get to level 80. See you soon.